Good morning, my brothers and sisters globally. Hello, all brothers and sisters globally from all over the world. Thank you very much for joining this global marathon, billion happy life subscribers for happiness. We are doing in this series of mind discovery a great study of world scriptures. We try to practice it daily. So let's start reading them. We into the chapters. Interdependence. Other chapters you could see in previous videos and get inspired and vibe for all day. All beings, great and small, are linked in a web of interdependent relationship. Apart from the whole, no individual could exist. Therefore, to think of myself as a separate individual is a fundamental error of cognition. Einstein called it an optical delusion of consciousness, a kind of prison for us, restricting us to our personal desire and to affection for a few persons nearest to us. He said that we should free ourselves from this prison by widening our circle of compassion to embrace all living creatures and the whole of nature in all its beauty. In reality, every being is immersed in a web of cause and effect, a chain of concatenation, according to a Buddhist text, that stretches to the end of the universe. This understanding is the basic of the Buddhist teaching of non-self, recognizing that all beings are I am all beings. It is the root of the Buddhist ethic of compassion. It is the remedy for the malady of individualism, which leads people to believe that the goal is my salvation. In fact, no human beings can attain ultimate peace as long as other people are suffering. We are members one of another. Ephesians 4:25. This world of man given over to the idea of I am the agent, bound up with the idea another is the agent. Understand not truly this thing. They have not seen it as a thorn, for one who looks at this thorn with the caution, the idea I am the agent exists not, the idea another is the agent exists not. Udana 70 Buddhist. All things are devoid of self-nature, separate existence, have never been born, and in their original nature are transparent like the sky. Things separated from concatenation belong to the discrimination of the ignorant. When this entire world is regarded as a concatenation, as nothing else but concatenation, then the mind gains tranquility. Lankavatara Sutra 78 Buddhist. Why should I be unable to regard the bodies of others as I? It is not difficult to see that my body, it is also that of others, in the same way as the hands and so forth are regarded as limbs of the body. Likewise, why are embodied creatures not regarded as limbs of life? only through acquaintance has the thought of I rising. Toward this impersonal body, so in a similar way, why should it not arise toward other living beings? When I work in this way for the sake of others, I should not let concept or the feeling that I am wonderful arise. It is just the like feeling myself. I hope for nothing in return. Shaditi give a guide to the Bodhisattva way of life 8, 112, 16 Buddhist. It is because everyone under heaven recognize beauty as beauty that the idea of ugliness exists. And if everyone recognized virtue as virtue, this would merely create rash conception of wickedness. For truly being not being grow out of one another, Tao Te Ching, Tu Tao Te, all humans are caught in an indescribable network of mutuality, tied in single garment of destiny. Whatever affects one directly affects all indirectly. I can never be what I ought to be until you are what you ought to be. And you can never be what you ought to be until I own to be. Martin Luther King Jr. Christianity. And to receive heavenly fortune today, let's read further with the teaching of Second Coming Messiah. In the universe, everything is linked and related from the minute things to the larger. Every existence is linked to another through dual purposes. One purpose pertains to internal character and the other to external form. The purpose pertaining to the internal character is for the whole, while the purpose pertaining to external form is the individual. These relate to each other as cause and effect, internal and external, and subject and object. Therefore, there cannot be any purpose of the individual apart from the purpose of the whole, not any purpose of the whole that does not include the purpose of the individual. All the creatures in the entire universe form a vast complex linked together by these dual purposes. When all beings in the universe and the whole universe with the subject and object partners well adjusted to each other are linking to one another in harmony for a common purpose, there is completion and perfection. The universe is balanced, all composed of reciprocal relationship, larger and small. Without reciprocal relationship, nothing can exist. Anything that ceases there to relate becomes extinct. Heavenly fortune rejects those who live for their own sake and embrace those who live for the sake of others. It is like a person who is nearly blind, suddenly seen with 20/20 vision. His eyes exclaim for joy, "Wow, we can see everything very clearly." Through heaven's power, we are connected to the entire universe and can see all of for eternity. This power penetrates everything infinitely, hence our scope of action expands infinitely. By living for the sake of others, we can make a relationship with everything. In the human body, the eyes look very simple, but it is actually complex. Each cell that make up the eye is complex as well. All the organs are complex, but in living together a simple organism, they do not conflict with each other. Instead, they function together interdependently. No part of the body can say that I like only the hand and does not like the eye. each organ has its lawful place and each accommodates itself to the limitations of its position and rank relating to other front and back, left and right, and above and below. That is the only way it can function. There is no other way. Each human being is like a cell. They do not exist separately, each doing their own thing. Rather, they come together and form a whole, creating an axis. And then humankind can enter into the partnership with God, the center of the whole, the force of the love flowing in this partnership motivates them to pursue a common objective. Cause and effect correspond to each other and fulfill their purpose. When the cause and effect are thus united, God and the whole humankind manifest their value and complete their own common purpose. The supreme element that we human beings pursue is love. Therefore, we should make it so the give and take of love proceeds smoothly. The universe should be linked by one axis formed when each person centers on his or her subject partner. Then, just like an electrical circuit, everything can engage in good and give and take action through the axis. It is similar to a tree whose parts engage in give and take action centering on the trunk. Through that axis, every cell forms the bottommost tip of the central root to the terminal bud of the very top, relate to each other continually. If that give and take action is good, the tree will grow. If not, the root will shrivel and the whole tree will decline. And now let's read from my book, God's Global Trends, Spiritual World and God. Spiritualists say that almost 88% of our thoughts, ideas, and self-talks are tips from another people from spiritual world. Sometimes these are good ideas, but sometimes they are really wrong and even detrimental to ourselves and other people around. If he could prove that these conversations are actually input from other people, we would be surprised that some of the biggest achievements in history have actually been collaborative efforts, from dream seeing periodic table to the apple falling on a head that discovered gravitation through experience in nature, laboratories, and even bathrooms. We might not have always been thinking alone during this great aha moment, but don't be led by this thought automatically. Take control of them by divine principles, since it could lead in wrong direction, as we see some politicians influence even religious people to start armed conflict. Even more significant is that we are not only connected through technology, but we are connected to each other spiritually as living beings. We are connected with the spirit world and with God, as testified by many spiritualists. It is evident when we hear stories of people dreaming of their relatives who went to the spiritual world. Many scientists and business people are also receiving revelation and great ideas through dreams, as we mentioned above. People are also having experiences of dying and coming back with similar stories about what happened and where they went while they were dead, often describing another world where they met family members who passed away. We all feel God's love in our grandparents because naturally people are raising their love during their life, preparing for next spiritual world of love. We should understand it clearly that the numerous saints and sages who have lived on earth throughout history are actually still living on in the spirit world. They are existing God's providence. They are assisting God's providence on earth. Each moment in our earthly life is recorded in the spirit world exactly as it takes place. On the day when we cross over the spirit world, our life's record will become a basis for judgment. That is why all human beings should practice a life of true love and sacrifice themselves for greater cause in their lifetime. Yeah, this is the message for today, brother and sister. Thank you very much for joining this global marathon of happy billion live subscribers. Please like this video, subscribe it, and share it with all your friends to grow this marathon and join this great marathon of mind discovery. This is very important because mind is the source of intellect, emotions, and will. So we're supposed to be tuned to our mind, and as we read in the world scriptures, by living for the sake of others, when we start to live for the sake of others, our family, community, city, country, and the world, we will be as Messiah, second coming said, we will receive heavenly fortune and reject those who live for their own sake and embrace those who live for the sake of others. It is like a person who nearly blind suddenly see with 20/20 vision. His eyes exclaim for joy, wow, we can see everything very clearly. So please see very clearly today, brothers and sisters, receive this heavenly fortune and make morning exercise and tune to this vibe of the universe divine principle and practice through love. Wish you a great day today. See you tomorrow. Join online or watch the video and share it with all your friends. Have a great day and contact me anytime for cooperation.